Okay, so I was showing the video. So first he made a hole inside the slab, then now he will insert a rubber bolt and press it inside with the help of a hammer. Now this is the bolt that he will insert to fix on it. Machine will be fixed. You can see that machine is placed, and now he will tighten the nut over the bolt. This is the nut that he will tighten it. Now there are four other screws in black color. He will tighten these screws. They will produce a reaction from the ground and tighten the machine so that it should not tilt in any direction. It should not move at all. It will be permanently fixed. You can see that he is checking that it is properly fixed. Now the handle is he is fixing the handle. This is the core bit through which a core is extracted. Now there is this knob is there through which he will attach a pipe for water supply during the coring. He's turning it on, and you can see that water is coming at the bottom from the core bit. Machine is on. Now slowly he will move it downward, and then the core pressure should be small. It should not be large pressure on the handle so that slowly it will cut the surface. Now you can see that he is doing coring.
सर अगर इसके दरमियान कोई रीबार आ जाए स्लैब में फिर
हाँ जी, वो भी साथ ही कट जाएगी उसके साथ ही। ये कटर इस तरह का है कि वो रीबार को भी काट देता है, ठीक है? लेकिन वी विल डिस्कस दैट दिस रीबार इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड इन द कोरिंग। इट इज मेंशन, वी विल स्कैन इट फर्स्ट, देन वी विल डू द कोरिंग। So this was the video. So you can also see it on YouTube. Just writing in the search Hilti core cutting machine, you will see this video by yourself again. Now, as I showed you that this is the over here in this slide, you can see that this core is extracted and he is getting one more core from the other location. So core is extracted in this form. So you should be knowing that what is the name of these. This is known as a core bit, and these are available in different diameters. From this machine, we can extract the cores in any orientation, horizontal, vertical, inclined. We can obtain the cores. Okay, now I will move to the standard from where we will study this test procedure. स्टैंडर्ड आई विल आल्सो शेयर विद यू ऑल द स्टैंडर्ड्स इन पीडीएफ फॉर्म लेटर. स्टैंडर्ड टेस्ट मेथड फॉर दिस इज ASTM C42 स्टैंडर्ड टेस्ट मेथड फॉर ऑब्टेनिंग एंड टेस्टिंग ड्रिल्ड कोर एंड शॉर्ट बीम्स ऑफ कॉन्क्रीट. सो आई विल फर्दर इंक्रीज द रूम सो दैट एवरीवन कैन सी. हाँ जी ठीक है, आप सबको नजर तो आ रहा है ना इतनी साइज पे, यू कैन रीड इट. दिस टेस्ट मेथड कवर्स ऑब्टेनिंग प्रिपेयरिंग एंड टेस्टिंग कोर्स ड्रिल फ्रॉम द कंक्रीट फॉर ए लेंथ और कंप्रेसिव स्ट्रेंथ स्प्लिटिंग टेंसाइल स्ट्रेंथ डिटर्मिनेशन. दिस टेस्ट मेथड इज नॉट एप्लीकेबल टू कोर्स फ्रॉम द शॉर्टक्रीट. सो द कोर्स दैट वी विल ऑब्टेन इट हैज टू पर्पसेस. वन इज if you want to get the information means you want to know how much is the slab thickness, how much are the floor finishes, so you can extract a core, and this is for length determination. Other purpose is to determine the compressive strength of the concrete or to determine the splitting tensile strength of the concrete. Now then, significance and use. We have this test method provides standardized procedure for obtaining and
sir, slides visible नहीं है.
Slide visible नहीं है. अच्छा.
Yes sir.
चलिए मैं दोबारा कोशिश करता हूँ.
सर वो आपकी YouTube वाली स्क्रीन स्क्रीन शेयर हो रही है अभी तक.
अच्छा
yes, चलिए मैं अभी तक आपकी सर YouTube वाली विंडो ही शो हो रही है.
ठीक है मैं दोबारा करता हूँ, एक मिनट है. देखें आप शो हो रही है स्लाइड.
यस सर शो हो रही है सर.
चलो ठीक है ओके. सो सिग्निफिकेंस एंड यूज, दिस टेस्ट मेथड प्रोवाइड स्टैंडर्डाइज्ड प्रोसीजर फॉर ऑब्टेनिंग एंड टेस्टिंग स्पेसिमेंस टू डिटरमिन द कंप्रेसिव स्ट्रेंथ टेंसाइल स्ट्रेंथ एंड फ्लेक्सुरल स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ इन प्लेस कॉन्क्रीट. So in this test method that the core that will be obtained, core will be used to determine the compressive strength and the separating tensile strength. But if you could obtain the beam specimen from a slab, then you can test it for modulus of rupture. Generally, test specimens are obtained when doubt exists about the in-place concrete quality. Due either to the low strength test results during the construction or signs of distress in the structure. Another use of this test method is to provide strength information on older structures. अच्छा इसमें दो चीजें हैं कि एक तो अगर हमारी new building है तो उस for the new building we don't have in this class foreign student के है कोई हमारे group में.
No sir.
कोई नहीं है चलें फिर ठीक है ओके. सो देर आर टू पर्पसेस फॉर दिस टेस्टिंग. वन इज फॉर द न्यू स्ट्रक्चर एंड इन द न्यू स्ट्रक्चर इफ द स्पेसिमन दैट वर कास्ट एट द टाइम ऑफ कंस्ट्रक्शन दे शोड द सिलेंड्रिकल स्पेसिमन दे शोड द लेस स्ट्रेंथ और देर इज ए सम डिस्ट्रेसेस. डिस्ट्रेसेस मीन सम क्रैक्स आर अपीयर्ड, देर इज ए डिफ्लेक्शन इज अपीयर्ड इन द स्ट्रक्चर. Then you can test the concrete strength. You have to investigate what are the reasons for this distress, and for that purpose, we need to extract the cores from the structure in order to determine their strength. Another use of this method is for the older structures. Sometimes in the older structures, we have to do the strength evaluation. We have to determine the load carrying capacity, and we do that for the analysis we need FC prime, and to determine the FC prime we extract the cores from the older structures. Now after that core strength is affected by the location of the concrete in a structural element, with concrete at the bottom tending to be stronger than the concrete at the top. Core strength is also affected by the orientation relative to the horizontal plane of the concrete as placed, with strength tending to be lower when measured parallel to the horizontal plane. These factors shall be considered in planning the locations for obtaining the concrete samples and in comparing the strength test results. Here I will give you one example. For example, we cast 1 meter high concrete. 1 meter high concrete. Concrete at the bottom will be of good quality. Concrete at the top will be of poor quality. And due to this reason, the core that is extracted at the bottom will give you the higher strength, and core that is extracted at the top will give you the lesser strength. Similarly, if from 1 meter height that you have cast, if you obtain a core horizontally from near the top, that core will give you some less strength. But if you obtain a core vertically from the top surface, you obtain a core, it will give you a larger strength. The reason is that at the top it is lesser, at the bottom it is more. So average strength will be more than as compared to the horizontal core taken at the top. The next is the strength of the concrete measured by the test of the cores is affected by the amount of distribution of moisture in the specimen at the time of the test. And there is no standard procedure to condition a specimen that will ensure that at the time of the test, it will be in identical moisture condition as the concrete in the structure. So the moisture conditioning procedure in this test method are intended to provide reproducible moisture condition that minimizes within laboratory and between laboratory variations and to reduce the effects of moisture induced during the specimen preparation. So one thing, please remember, when we extract the core from the structure, the moisture is lost from the surface. And that moisture condition of the concrete is not representable as that of the specimen in the structure. But there is a moisture conditioning guidelines are given in the standard. These guidelines ensure that you are testing all the cores in a uniform moisture condition. And the variability in the results between in the laboratory and between the laboratories, it should be lesser. Now, next is 3.5. The measured compressive strength of a core will generally be less than that of a corresponding properly molded and cured cylindrical cylinder at the same age. For a given concrete, however, there is no unique relationship between the strength of these two types of specimens. The relationship is affected by many factors such as the strength level of the concrete, the in-place temperature and the moisture histories, the degree of consolidation, batch-to-batch variability, strength gain characteristics of the concrete, and condition of the coring apparatus, and the care used in removing the cores. Here, one thing please remember, the specimen, the concrete cylinders that are prepared, they are cured in water for 28 days. This type of curing is not given for the structure, that actual structure. We cannot provide for continuous water curing for the structure. And due to the reasons that are mentioned at the bottom, the rate of gain, the heat of hydration will be different in the small specimen as compared to in the large structure. So these all things, the consolidation and compaction will be different in the cylinder as well as in the structure. So all these conditions, due to all these conditions, they say that the core that we obtain from the structure, they will show the lesser strength as compared to the cylinders that were cast at the time of construction. So here, then how to accept if the core is giving us the lesser results, then how to accept the results. So for this, there is a lines are written in note number 4. I am highlighting these lines over here. So according to ACI 318, the concrete represented by cores is considered structurally adequate if the average strength of the three cores is at least 85% of FC prime, and no single core strength is less than 75% of the FC prime. तो ये गाइडलाइन है जिसकी वजह से हम उसको एक्सेप्ट या रिजेक्ट कर सकते हैं कंक्रीट को इफ द एवरेज ऑफ द थ्री कोर्स इज नॉट लेस देन 85% ऑफ द एफसी प्राइम एंड नो सिंगल कोर इज लेस देन 75% ऑफ द एफसी प्राइम So then you can accept the results. Now there is a term will be used in this standard specifier of the test. Referred in this test is an individual responsible for analysis or review and acceptance of the core results. Now next is the apparent compressive strength of the concrete as measured by the core is affected by length to diameter ratio of the cores. Length to diameter ratio of the cores as tested, and this must be considered in preparing the core specimens and evaluating the test results. So if you remember, we discussed in the class, I think, the end platen effect. Kiya tha class mein discuss, aapki class mein ki nahi kiya hua?
Yes, sir, kiya tha.
Sir, kiya hua hai.
Kiya hua hai. Main phir bhi aapko thoda sa bata deta hu ke jo ye end platen effect hai, isme humne is tarah ki figure bana ke usko show kiya tha, cylinder aur cube ke andar. So cylinder mein when we apply the load in the machine, there is three zones are formed. One, two are the end zones, one is the central zone. At the end zone, there is a friction that is shown in the blue color arrow, friction between the platen of the machine and the specimen surface, top surface. That friction, it restricts the movement of the specimen outward. So when the load is applied, there is the specimen will try to move outward side as shown in the red arrows. And this can happen in the central zone, but it is restricted in the end zones due to the end platen effect or the friction. So these, and when the tensile stress is in the central zone, increase the tensile strength, cracking will appear. And this crack will propagate in the end zones at the larger loads, and then the failure will take place. But in case of cube specimen, there is no central zone. So all the portions are subjected to complex stresses, and due to which it takes the larger load. And due to the absence of the this end zone, it takes in central zone, due to absence of the central zone, it takes more load in case of the cube, and it shows the higher strength. And we discussed that the strength of the cylinder, it is about 80% of the cube strength if we consider the end platen effect. Now if you only concentrate on the cylindrical specimens, this is at this time ideal size, L over D ratio equal to 2, standard size of the cylinder. But as you decrease the height of the cylinder, the central zone height will start decreasing, and due to which the more effect of the end platens will be there, and the more load carrying capacity will be more load carrying capacity will be there. So as the L over D ratio becomes smaller than 2, near to 1, towards 1 it will be exactly like a cube. So between 1 and 2 it is between cube and cylinder. So the load carrying capacity will increase as the central zone height will decrease. Okay? So this due to and so there are two parameters. One is the end platen effect along with the L over D ratio. So these two effects are considered in the compressive strength determination. So we will see next one, core apparatus. We have seen the core drills. Saw is required to trimming the core ends, and balance is required at least to 5 grams accuracy. Then sampling. Okay, sampling mein kya hai? Samples of hardened concrete for use in preparation of the strength test specimen shall not be taken until the concrete is strong enough to permit the sample removal without disturbing the bond between the mortar and the coarse aggregates. When preparing the test specimens from the samples of hardened concrete, samples that have been damaged during removal shall not be used unless the damaged portions are removed and length of the resulting test specimens satisfy the minimum length to diameter ratio requirements. Samples of defective or damaged concrete that cannot be tested shall be reported along with the reason that prohibits the sample from preparing the strength test. So the important thing is at what minimum age we should extract the cores. So this is given in note number 7 at the bottom. So if time permits, the concrete should not be removed before it is 14 days old. At age of 14 days, generally about 80% of the strength is achieved. So at this time, after 14 days, you can remove the core from the structure. Okay, so time is mentioned in the standard. Minimum age is 14 days. Now, next is, except as provided in 5.1.3, cores containing embedded reinforcement, excluding fibers or other embedded objects, shall not be used for determining the strength of the concrete. So in order to use this criteria, we have to do the scanning of the slabs, walls or the columns, and we mark the location of the reinforcement through the reinforcement scanner. Once it is marked, then we can select the location from where we will extract the cores that will not result in any reinforcement. But in 5.3, it is mentioned that if it is not possible to prepare a test specimen that meets the requirements of 7.1 and 7.2, 7.1 and 7.2 explain the size requirements, and it is free of the embedded reinforcement or other metal, the specifier of the test is permitted to allow testing of the concrete with embedded metal. If the core tested for strength contains embedded metal, the size, shape, location of the metal within the core shall be documented in the test report. वो उसके अंदर वो उसको mention करना है उस report में कि वो कहाँ पे उसके lie कर रही है. Okay, next, core drilling. Core को drill करने के लिए, when a core will be tested to measure the concrete strength, when it is required to determine the concrete strength, the core shall be drilled perpendicular to the surface at least 150 millimeter away from the formed joints or obvious edges of a unit of deposit. So, ये important है कि whenever you extract the core, it should be six inch away. From the form joints or the ends of the deposit. The minimum distance does not apply to the formed boundaries of the structural members. Record the appropriate angle between the longitudinal axis and the drilled core and the horizontal plane of the concrete as placed. A specimen drilled perpendicular to a vertical surface or a perpendicular to a sloping surface shall be taken from a near to the middle of a unit. Because middle ke upar uski average quality hogi, we should get the from the middle of the deposit when possible. If cores are obtained for the purpose other than determination of the strength, drill cores in accordance with the instructions provided by the specifier of the test. Record the date core was drilled. If known, record the date when concrete was placed. Slab removal. Slab removal mein kya hai? We need the to remove a slab removal for a modulus of rupture test. Remove a slab sufficiently large to secure the desired test specimen without the inclusion of any concrete that has been cracked, bald, undercut, or otherwise damaged. Okay, then is the drilling cores. There are two objectives. One is to measure the length of the drilled cores. Second is to measure the compressive strength. So first we discuss how the cores required to measure the length. What are the requirement of diameter and the length? The core for determining the thickness of the pavement, slabs, walls, or other structure elements shall have a diameter at least 94 millimeter. When the lengths of such cores are to be measured in accordance with C-174. On the other hand, when the cores for determining the thickness of a member are not required to be measured in C174, core diameter shall be as directed by the specifier of the test. अगर आप C174 को सेटिस्फाई करना चाह रहे हैं तो कोर का डायमीटर मिनिमम 94 मिलीमीटर होना चाहिए. अदरवाइज आप उससे स्मॉलर डायमीटर भी यूज कर सकते हैं, वो डिपेंड करता है वो स्पेसिफायर ऑफ द टेस्ट वो क्या रिकमेंड करता है आपको. फॉर कोर्स दैट आर नॉट इंटेंडेड फॉर डिटरमिनिंग द स्ट्रक्चरल डायमेंशंस, मेजर द लॉन्गेस्ट एंड द शॉर्टेस्ट लेंथ ऑन द कट सरफेस अलोंग द लाइंस पैरेलल टू द कोर एक्सिस, रिकॉर्ड द एवरेज लेंथ टू द नियरेस्ट ऑफ 5 मिलीमीटर. उसको 5 मिलीमीटर के में उसको मल्टीपल में रिपोर्ट करेंगे लेंथ को. नाउ वी विल डिस्कस द कोर्स रिक्वायर्ड फॉर कंप्रेसिव स्ट्रेंथ डिटरमिनेशन. उसमें डायमीटर की क्या रिक्वायरमेंट है. एक्सेप्ट एज प्रोवाइडेड इन 7.1.2 द डायमीटर ऑफ द कोर स्पेसिमेंस फॉर डिटरमिनेशन ऑफ कंप्रेसिव स्ट्रेंथ शैल बी एटलीस्ट 94 मिलीमीटर और एटलीस्ट 2 times द नॉमिनल मैक्सिमम साइज ऑफ एग्रीगेट्स विच एवर इज लार्जर. So here there are 2 criteria, larger of 2 values, one is 94 millimeter, second is 2 times the maximum aggregate size. So in the next point, it is explained smaller diameters are also acceptable if limited member thickness makes it impossible to obtain a core with length to diameter ratio of L over D of at least 1, or if the clear distance between the reinforcement is limited. Core diameters less than 94 millimeters are not prohibited. If core diameters less than 94 millimeter is used, report the reason. देखिए इसमें दो चीजें हैं. एक तो हमें L over D को satisfy करना है. कम से कम L over D जो हम core test कर सकते हैं वो 1 है. और ideal जो condition है वो 2 है ideal core की. अगर हम 1 भी ना achieve कर सकें, for example, our core diameter is equal to 6 inches. And slab depth is equal to 5 inches. So L over D जो रेशियो होगी उसकी वो 1 से कम होगी L over D, ठीक है. और 5/6 आएगा तो वो 1 से कम है. इसका मतलब है वी शुड यूज द स्मॉलर कोर्स. फॉर दैट पर्पज 3 inch कोर विल बी सफिशेंट. सो देन 3 विल बी डायमीटर एंड लेंथ विल बी 5 inches. सो 5/3 इट विल बी मोर देन 1 less than 2. Still, we can use the core for testing. Now, other is that, for example, in case of columns, we want to extract a column. Clear distance between the reinforcement in the column is very small, and in that case, smaller diameter is also permitted. For example, if we can say that there is a clear gap of 2 inch between the bars, so you can use a diameter of 1.5 inch diameter of a core. Core diameter you can use. Smaller diameters are also acceptable if there is a congestion of the reinforcement. So next is length. We discussed the diameter. Now next is the length. Except as provided in 7.2.2, the preferred length of the capped or the ground specimen is between 1.9 and 2.1 times the diameter. If the ratio of the length to diameter of the core exceeds 2.1, reduce the length of the core so that the ratio of the capped or the ground specimen is between 1.9 and 2.1. Core specimen with length to diameter ratio equal to or less than 1.75 requires a correction factor on the measured compressive strength. So we will go to this section 7.9.1. Over here, please see, as I explained to you, due to the end platen effect, the load carrying capacity will be more, and we have to apply a reduction in the strength to compare it with L over D ratio equal to 2. So over here, this table is given. If L over D ratio is 1.75, factor is 0.98. And if it is 1, strength correction factor, if L over D ratio is 1 near to the cube and you want to compare with the cylinder, then you have to multiply by 0.87. It means that 13% strength you will reduce it for the test, and that strength you will report as the compressive strength of the core. ठीक है, ये समझ आ गई आपको इस टेबल की. जब आपने एल ओवर डी रेशियो को डिस्कस करना है, तो आपने ये फैक्टर अप्लाई करने हैं जिसकी वजह से आपको स्ट्रेंथ, जब आप ये फैक्टर अप्लाई कर देंगे तो स्ट्रेंथ विल बी इक्विवेलेंट टू एल ओवर डी रेशियो इक्वल टू टू, तो उसके बराबर होगी, ठीक है। ओके, वी विल गो बैक टू द प्रीवियस पैराग्राफ। ओके, अब ये पॉइंट बड़ा इंपॉर्टेंट है यहाँ पे कि कब कोर टेस्ट नहीं की जा सकती। ए कोर हैविंग ए मैक्सिमम लेंथ लेस देन 95% ऑफ इट्स डायमीटर बिफोर कैपिंग और ए लेंथ लेस देन इट्स डायमीटर आफ्टर कैपिंग ट्रिमिंग और एंड ग्राइंडिंग शैल नॉट बी यूज्ड। सो लेस देन 1 डायमीटर कोर्स आर नॉट एक्सेप्टेबल। सो इन द नेक्स्ट पैराग्राफ इट इज एक्सप्लेन्ड इफ द कंप्रेसिव स्ट्रेंथ of the cores are to be compared with the specified strength based on the standard concrete cubes, core shall be tested with L over D after end preparation in the range of 1 to 1.05 unless otherwise directed by the specifier of the test. If the strength of the cores with L over D ratio equal to 1 are to be compared with the FC prime of the cubes, do not apply specified strength of the cubes, do not apply the correction factor. अच्छा, इसमें दो चीज़ें हैं। इस पैराग्राफ में जो चीज़ बताई जा रही है वो ये है कि अगर आप अपने कंप्रेसिव स्ट्रेंथ को क्यूब स्ट्रेंथ के साथ कंपेयर करना चाह रहे हैं, उस केस में जो एल ओवर डी रेशियो होनी चाहिए कोर की, वो 1 से लेके 1.05 तक होनी चाहिए। और जब आप ये वाला फैक्टर को यूज़ करेंगे, जब उसको क्यूब के साथ कंपेयर करेंगे, तो जो फैक्टर हमने अभी टेबल में देखे थे वो हम इस्तेमाल नहीं करेंगे, क्योंकि वो फैक्टर सिर्फ एप्लीकेबल है किस केस में, के जब हमारे पास वो सिलेंडर स्पेसिमन होगा, जब हमने उसको सिलेंडर के साथ कंपेयर करना है। लेकिन जब क्यूब के साथ कंपेयर करना है तो जब एल ओवर डी वन होगा तो आप उसको एज सच जो स्ट्रेंथ आएगी उसी को यूज कर लेंगे, क्योंकि हम क्यूब के साथ कंपेयर कर रहे हैं। लेकिन जब हमने सिलेंडर के साथ कंपेयर करना है तो फिर हमने उसको एल ओवर डी के जो फैक्टर्स हैं वो हम लगाएंगे। सो नेक्स्ट इज द मॉइस्चर कंडीशनिंग। Now, moisture conditioning is explained over here. Test the cores after moisture conditioning as specified in this test method or as directed by the specifier of the test. The moisture conditioning procedures specified in this test method are intended to prevent the moisture of the drilled cores and provide a reproducible moisture condition that minimizes the effect of moisture gradient introduced by wetting during the drilling and the span and the specimen preparation. So what is the procedure? After cores have been drilled, wipe off the surface drilled water and allow the remaining surface moisture to evaporate. When the surface appears dry but not later than 1 hour after drilling, place the cores in separate plastic bags and seal to prevent moisture loss. Maintain the cores at ambient temperature and protect the from the exposure to the direct sunlight. Transport the cores to the testing laboratory as soon as possible. Keep the cores in plastic bags at all times except during the end preparation or for maximum time of 2 periods to permit the capping before testing. If water is used during sighing or grinding of the core ends, complete these operations as soon as possible, but not later than 2 days after drilling of the cores, unless stipulated otherwise by the specifier of the test. After completing the end preparation, wipe off the surface moisture, allow the surface to dry, and place the cores in a sealed plastic bags or non-absorbent containers. Minimize the duration of the exposure to the water. Allow the cores to remain in the sealed plastic bags for at least 5 days after last being wetted or before testing, unless stipulated otherwise by the specifier of the test. So, इसमें मैं इसको summarize कर देता हूँ दोबारा से। जब आपने core extract की है, तो we will wash it to remove the dust and the we will place it in the normal environment. When the water will dry, when the surface will dry, we will place it in the plastic bag. After that, we will bring to the laboratory, and then we will place it in the laboratories. And after that, within 2 days, we have to do the end grinding, end cutting, and end grinding. once it is finished, then you will again place it in the plastic bag and you will wait for 5 days. After 5 days, you will test it. After 5 days, you will test it. So total time within 7 days, you have to test the cores, not beyond the 7 days after removing the cores from the site. Now, next is when direction is given to test the cores in moisture condition other than the previous procedure, report the alternative procedure. So aapne usko alternate procedure report karna hai. Sighing of the ends. The end of the cores to be tested in the compression shall be flat and perpendicular to the longitudinal axis in accordance with C39. If necessary, saw the end of the cores that will cap so that prior to capping the following requirements are met. Two conditions that projections, if any, shall not extend more than 5 millimeters above the end surface. And then the end surfaces shall not depart from perpendicularity to the longitudinal axis by a slope of more than 1:0.3D, where D is the average core diameter in millimeters. If the density is required, calculate the density in 20 kilograms per cubic meter of concrete. Now, capping. In this paragraph, two methods are explained. One is the bonded caps according to C617, and one is the unbonded caps in accordance with C1231. So there are two types of caps, bonded and unbonded. Bonded caps, for example, these are the sulfur capping and the plaster of Paris capping. The unbonded caps are the rubber caps. So both you can use bonded or unbonded caps. But based on the capping, we have to take the measurements. How to take the measurements? Length. If the core will be tested with the bonded caps, determine the average length before and after capping and use the length after capping to compute the L over D ratio. Okay? जो फिर कैपिंग के बाद वाली लेंथ है उसको यूज करेंगे एल ओवर डी रेशो की कैलकुलेशन में. इफ कोर विल बी टेस्टेड विद अनबॉन्डेड कैप्स और विद द ग्राउंड एंड, डिटरमिन द एवरेज लेंथ ऑफ द प्रिपेयर्ड कोर्स बिफोर टेस्टिंग. डिटरमिन द एवरेज लेंथ ऑफ द कोर टू द नियरेस्ट ऑफ 1 millimeter और 1 millimeter अकॉर्डिंग टू द मेथड C1542 or C174. So 1 millimeter के multiple में आपने उसकी length को report करना है. Length को 1 millimeter पे, अब उसके बाद है diameter. Diameter कैसे measure करेंगे? Determine the average diameter by averaging two diameter taken at right angle at each other at the mid height. Core की mid height के ऊपर 90 degree के ऊपर दो diameters measure करेंगे. Record the average core diameter to nearest point 2 millimeter. If the difference in the core diameter does not exceed 2% of the average, otherwise record the diameter nearest to 1 millimeter. And then यहाँ पे एक again है कि जब आपने core test नहीं करनी, do not test the core if the difference between the larger and the smallest diameter exceeds 5% of the average. अगर वो 5% से ज्यादा उसमें differ कर दे average से, तो तब भी आपने core को use नहीं करना. Now, अब टेस्टिंग में क्या है? टेस्टिंग हम करेंगे कंप्रेशन टेस्टिंग. C39 जो है वो स्टैंडर्ड है फॉर कंप्रेशन टेस्टिंग ऑफ द सिलेंडर्स. तो आपने कंप्रेशन टेस्ट करना है एंड विद इन 7 days आफ्टर कोरिंग इट शुड बी कंप्लीटेड. नाउ कैलकुलेशन. कैलकुलेट द कंप्रेसिव स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द ईच स्पेसिमन यूजिंग द कंप्यूटेड क्रॉस सेक्शनल एरिया बेस्ड ऑन द एवरेज कोर डायमीटर ऑफ द स्पेसिमन. तो आपने कैलकुलेशन कंप्रेसिव स्ट्रेंथ कैलकुलेट करनी है और इस कंप्रेसिव स्ट्रेंथ को करेक्ट करना है बेस्ड ऑन द फैक्टर बेस्ड ऑन एल ओवर डी रेशियो जो कि यहाँ पे गिवन है. ठीक है. सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट दिस टेस्ट. एट द बॉटम इट इज जस्ट द रिपोर्ट इज मेंशन. कंप्रेसिव स्ट्रेंथ को आपने 10 PSI के मल्टीपल में रिपोर्ट करना होगा. 10 PSI के मल्टीपल में. और अगर मेगा पास्कल में रिपोर्ट करेंगे तो 0.1 मेगा पास्कल के मल्टीपल में उसको रिपोर्ट करेंगे. ओके. नाउ आई विल शो यू द टेबल दैट there is a page number 38. On page number 38, there is a blank page. On this blank page, you will draw this table. So table mein we have serial number, weight in grams, length in inches, diameter in inches, load in tons, area in inch square, L over D ratio, and factor based on L over D ratio will be calculated. Strength will be calculated in PSI and steel. Okay, the factors that we have discussed in the previous table, that factors for intermediate values, you can interpolate. You will interpolate the factors. So over here we have three samples, weight, length, diameter, load, and steel is present or not, it is given. So these are the information, observations are given. Now you have to do the calculation, calculation of area, calculation of L over D, calculation of the factor, and calculation of the strength. Strength will be calculated based on the equation that is given at the bottom. P is the load in tons into 2204 pounds divided by area, and you will get the strength in PSI multiplied with the factor that is obtained in this column. So I have calculated these values in the next slide. So area is 5.31, L over D ratio is 1.15, factor is 0.906. So when you calculate load multiplied 2204 divided by area 5.31 into 0.906, and this is the compressive strength is calculated, and in the multiple of nearest multiple of 10 is reported. So in this way, you will report this table in your manual. Please check how these factors are calculated by yourself. When you will fill this table, you should be knowing how the interpolation is done for these to obtain this factor. Okay, so this is all about today's discussion. Now I will stop the recording, then I will take the questions from you if you have any question in this